Let's start by coming over to our Create tab in the top left of our screen. We're going to click on it, and we're going to select Document from the dropdown. Now we're going to name our document, and then we're going to hit Create Public Document. This is going to create for us our part. As you can see, on the left side of the screen, there's the origin, which is a center point from where you create everything. There are also three planes. There's a top plane, a front plane, and a right plane. So what we're going to do is we're going to select the front plane. I'm going to click on it, and then I'm going to come over here to Sketch, and I'm going to click on Sketch. Now we're inside a sketch on the front plane. In order to look directly normal to this plane, I'm going to come over here to the right side of the screen and click on Front. And that's going to make us look normal to the front, right at the front plane. I'm going to start by coming over here to where it says Line, the most basic building block of a sketch. I'm going to click on it, and I'm going to hover here, click down, drag across, click again, and now I've created a line on the front plane. I can also continue to drag the line around. I can create a second line attached to the first, a third line attached to the second, and if I connect them, now I have a closed profile. So with this closed profile, I'm going to hit Escape on the keyboard, and that's going to bring me out of our line tool. And then I'm going to come over and hit this little check, and that's going to exit the sketch. We're now not in the sketch anymore. We're back to where we were when we started. So I'm going to come over here to Extrude, and I'm going to click on it. And there are many different options here. We're going to just click on our closed shape. And when I click on it, if I rotate around, you can see that it's actually extruded the shape. So there's an arrow here. I could click and drag on this arrow to move out and in this extruded shape. I can also choose to instead type in a dimension into this field. I could type in 5 inches. I could type in 5 millimeters. I could type in 5 feet. I could type in whatever value I want. And we're just going to hit check for OK. And that's going to get us out of our feature. So now that we have this extrusion created, we want to go ahead and do another type of extrusion. So I'm going to repeat what we did before. But instead of creating a new sketch on the front plane, now I'm going to create that sketch on one of the faces, one of the flat faces of this 3D shape. So I'm just going to select this one on top. I'm going to click on it, come over here, click on Sketch to start a sketch, and now we're in a sketch. And I can come and click on Center Point Circle, and I'm just going to click and then drag, and now we have this circle that I just created. And we're going to hit OK, get out of the sketch, come over here again to where it says Extrude, click on it, and this time, after we select the circle profile, I'm going to go and click on Remove instead of Add or New. So now that we've selected Remove, it's actually going to remove material. So I can drag this up and down. I'm going to drag all the way through this part and hit OK. And now you could see I made a hole in this shape. So now that we have the extrusion and the extrude cut out of the way, let's go a little bit more advanced. I'm going to go back to my sketch. Now, let's say I wanted to change this profile. I can right-click on the sketch one and hit Edit. We can come over to our view cube and click on Front to look normal to the front plane. and I'm going to come right here to dimension, click on it, and if I click on the top line, it'll drag out whatever size this line already is. I'm going to change this dimension to be 3 and hit enter, and it'll automatically make it 3 inches by default. So now that we've created this dimension, what I can do is click escape, and now we see that there's this sort of shape that comes up. We're going to just click on this symbol and hit delete. And we're also going to click on this symbol that comes up when you hover, click on it and hit delete. And we can just take these two lines and move them and make them touch, and then they will be connected and create this closed profile. So I'm going to hit OK to exit the sketch. And now we're going to see that it's changed the whole shape. And we could actually take this another step further. We can add a fillet. So I'm going to come over to this feature, Fillet, and click on it. And then I'm going to click on this line. And it's going to fillet that edge. And you can see that. And let's hit OK. Now, the reason why I'm able to revolve this around, you might be wondering, is because I'm using a 3D mouse. But you can do all of your movement really with the view cube. You can click on it and hit front, or you can click on a corner of the cube to look at an isometric, and you can rotate it around like that if you don't yet have a 3D mouse. Let's add a little bit more complexity to our model here. We're going to click on right for the right plane. You can select it either in the view window, or you could select it from your feature tree right here. Click on it and click on sketch. And now we're in a sketch on the right plane. I'm going to click on right on the view cube. And this time we're going to click on line. I'm going to create this line, hit escape. And now I'm going to come over to where it says 3-point arc, click on it, click on this top point, and we're going to drag this out, click again, and when you move your mouse, you're going to see that you can make this 3-point arc kind of wherever you want it to be. We'll just drag it out here, and I'll click on this point, and it'll create another one. And we're again going to drag this out. And we're going to come over and click on line. And we're going to just connect these two points here at the bottom and hit escape. So now I have a closed profile. I'm going to hit the check to exit the sketch. And I'm going to come over here to revolve. I'm going to click on it. And the first thing that I want to select is the closed profile. And then the second thing that I'm going to select is here, this red area. And I'm going to select that. And what it has done, I'm going to show you in 3D. It's basically, it's revolved this profile around this line. So imagine a lathe where this shape is being revolved around this axis. We're going to hit OK. And now we have this shape. So I think that's about it for the basics. And follow me on to the next tutorial to learn a little bit more about all of the capabilities we have here in Onshape.